AI is a machine's ability to perform cognitive functions that we would typically associate with an intelligent being. That includes functions like perceiving, reasoning, learning, and even interacting with the environment, and maybe even exercising some forms of creativity. So I'm Dr. Joel Davis. I'm a clinical faculty member at the Warrington College of Business at the University of Florida. I think we often think about AI as needing to relate to human intelligence in some way, and I'm not sure that it does have to relate to human intelligence, because I think computers can think and maybe should think differently than human beings. For example, you know, a machine is going to think hopefully in some rational way and towards some sort of rational goal, and we know that the human mind doesn't work like that. So we often see AI, especially in the news, being compared or being used to take things like an IQ test or the bar exam or the medical exam and passing with flying colors. And it makes the front page of these newspapers because it makes for an interesting story. But those tests, especially when you think of something like the IQ test, are really designed to test human intelligence. They have no bearing on machine intelligence whatsoever, and they shouldn't be used as such. And so a machine passing the IQ test doesn't tell us anything about the intelligence of a machine. AI encompasses quite a few fields, and a lot of the time we talk about them almost interchangeably. The number one, you know, field, especially in business, that we talk about a lot is machine learning. And that's really a subfield of artificial intelligence that focuses on the development of algorithms and statistical models that enable computers to perform tasks by learning from the data rather than being explicitly programmed for each specific task. So it can learn from the data, you know, what those features look like and how those features should relate to some sort of output. It's learning from the data, which we call machine learning. As a subfield of that, if you wanted to go even narrower, you know, a lot of the talk today is on things like deep learning, and that's a subset of machine learning that involves the use of artificial neural networks to progressively extract higher level of features with that raw input. But same thing, learning from that data in some sort of almost automated way. And then of course lately, all the rage is talking about GPTs or generative AI, and these models of generative AI, these large language models like ChatGPT, which is really popular right now, are just extensions of these deep learning models.